demo. All right, so let's take a look at this. This example is meant to show off a few of the OOPI features we've seen in these notes that were not present in the OOPI dots demo. So first, let's just see what this code does when we run it. When we run it, it starts, it creates a deck of cards, and then it creates new decks every time and draws the first card out of that new deck over and over again until it hits a duplicate. See this two of clubs, and if we look, actually the first card was a two of clubs. Total cards drawn and the total number of diamonds. Let's run this again, and here we see we draw, let's run it, there, that's a better example. So the six of spades was not the first card, the second card, but we eventually drew another six of spades. And of the diamonds, the only diamonds we drew is the eight of diamonds. So there's the diamonds drawn. Cool, so now we know what this is doing. Let's take a little bit of a look at how it's doing it. Great. To begin with, we have a class called playing card, and we have inside playing card an init. A playing card takes a number and a suit. The number would be a 1 for an ace, 2 for 2, all the way up to 10 for 10. 11 is a jack, 12 is a queen, and a 13 is a king. Okay? And the suit is 0, 1, 2, or 3. And to tell you the truth, this really deserves a good comment right here explaining that. In any case, we have to store those for the playing card. But then we need to be able to use a wrapper to turn these values into these strings. That's what wrapper does. Here's the format, left angle bracket, string of string, right angle bracket. The first string is the number name. The second string is the suit. The number name is just the number, unless it's like an ace or a jack, in which case it's that. And the suit names, of course, are spades and hearts, clubs, and diamonds. So where we store these is in playing card.number names and playing card.suit names. Here they are up here. These are class attributes, because why create number names and suit names as lists for every single instance when they should be the same for every single instance? It's a perfect example of where you would want to share these, which is why they're stored in class attributes. Great. So now we have init and wrapper. We also want this to be hashable, because we want to be able to put instances of playing cards into a set. So we have our get hashables. Inside our, to tell if two playing cards are equal, we make sure that the other one's a playing card, and we can make sure their numbers are equal and their suits are equal. For that reason, our hashables are number and suit. Great, so now we can test for equality and put these things in a set. So now we're pretty close, but let's look at this next thing. There's this function called getDeck. It creates a deck. For every possible number and suit, it creates a playing card. So that creates 52 playing cards. And for each playing card, it appends it to the deck. So now the deck is a list of 52 playing cards. And then, if you want it shuffled, it goes ahead and shuffles the deck and returns this shuffled deck. Now, this is a function. It does not take a playing card. There's no self here as a playing card. So it's a function. But this function really only makes sense with regards to playing cards, which is why we made it a static method. It's a function defined inside the playing card class. Good example of a static method. Okay, notice static methods can create instances of the class that they're defined in. That's cool. All right, so now we've really seen the class. Let's look at what's going on. We start with a set of the cards we've seen and also counted the diamonds. Yep. Now we create a new deck, calling the static method of getDeck. We say the drawn card is the first card of the deck. We check if the suit is diamonds. What is this playing card.diamonds? Well, we know that diamonds are suit 1 because clubs are 0. We could have said if it equals a 1 down here, replace that with a 1. That would be terrible for several reasons. First, it reads terribly. There's no way we know that we're checking for diamonds, whereas here it reads clear as day that it's diamonds. Second, we can actually get the mapping wrong. Like, we thought one was diamonds, but two were diamonds, whereas here we can't do that at all. So this is just the better way to do it, period. Now, these are all caps because in many programming languages, you can declare values to be constant. which means they can't change. And then typically you make them all caps as a way to tell people this is a constant value, not a variable. Python, you don't have constants, but we still can suggest that by making this all caps, which I guess is a serving suggestion in Python saying, please keep this constant because changing it will break our code. So that's how we can tell if it's if the drawn suit is a diamond and add one to our diamond count. Otherwise, print the card. This is going to use the stir, or actually the repr method. If it's in the set, so naturally that's going to use that and adding it to the set are going to use the hash and the EQ. And otherwise, actually it turns out we don't have to shuffle this now. That was a holdover from a previous example. So now, because when we get a new deck, it will come out shuffled. So now, then we just go ahead and report the number of cards and the number of diamonds. So you see here, let's see a simple example, 4 with no diamonds, and we see here 4 again with 1 diamond. So it looks to be working fine. So again, this code as it is shows off a number of features that we just saw in the OOPI, in the OOP level 2 or part 2 notes. And between this and the OOPI dots demo, we've covered almost the entirety of those notes.